Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of Free Week. I am SchAmToo, and this is the week of June 16th, 2015. This week, we're going to be covering Kerrigan, the Queen of Blades. An absolute terror on any map, and a great roamer. So, without further ado, let's take our level 1 talent, exactly as I was saying during the guide, which is Sweeping Grasp. Absolutely amazing. Now, I will admit, full up front right now is that my W and E combos, sometimes they land, sometimes they don't. And you know what? The same thing will happen to you. But the thing that you really need to take in mind when you're playing Kerrigan is that you won't land all of your WEs, and that's okay. However, what you can do is start taking stock of what's going to be your team's advantage and what's going to be what you can take advantage of on the enemy team. Now, Gazlo, no escape. Sergeant Hammer, somewhat easy escape. Kerrigan, going to be another big threat. However, that Gazlo looks like he's going to be probably the best person to go against. Muradin, Vala can sometimes be a really good person to lock down. It's going to be a little bit difficult though because she's got that vault. So make sure that you don't overcommit and then she suddenly vaults away and you're left without too much. So we can WE and then all of a sudden you can see just how much damage we do, but there we go. I'm taking a good amount of damage myself, so it's a little bit scary. Hammer is down the bot lane, as we're getting told here. The other thing that I have to take into stock here is that I don't have any healers here. I have zero healers. I have to be very careful about when I go in. And that's the thing about Kerrigan, you know? She's really good at many things, but if you don't have a healer, you're going to be in a lot of trouble. So we will have to be a little bit careful of that and dodge out for those easy-to-dodge lasers. Maybe just go a little bit, do a little bit of damage here on that Muradin. Pull somebody in. Oh, I missed my WE. And that's okay. Remember, this is like a huge area to really cover here with your W and your E. So don't worry. Your opponents are going to try and dodge it. Try and wait until they won't be able to dodge it. That's the best advice that I could possibly give. Because sometimes they will be able to, sometimes they won't. And this might be me dying. Nope. Oh, actually, it might be gas or Nazebo. Yeah, Gazlo dying. I don't know why I was going to say Nazebo. Gazlo dying, but not like it's going to happen. And already we're apparently getting a whole bunch of kills in the bot lane. So, level 4 is coming here. Let's be a little bit more aggressive. Let's pick up that Envenom and go do some really fun things. Now, we can already see that even if I get my leap and probably start getting a little bit of damage in on this Vala, I could probably get her to be takedown very easily. I did walk through the lane, so it's not going to be too obvious, but still, we're gonna actually just walk over here. But look, Kerrigan, she's got no way to get out of this, right? And this is the thing. She's gonna have to walk into the blades. And Illidan, oh, Illidan! Run, my buddy! E? Proc? Nothing. So wait until your own opponent has to walk through an area where you can easily control it with a W and an E. Now they've got the Vala over there. I'm going to kind of try and sneak around here. So they do have that. And I'm able to pull her right back in there. And that's how you want to do it. You want to wait until she was trying to round that corner. But rounding that corner would have meant that I had an easy shot in order to actually pull her back into this. And remember, the other thing I was saying is she doesn't have an escape. She goes too hard like that Kerrigan just did, and guess what? She's now in a lot of trouble. I'm gonna back up here. Gonna jump in, pull him back. Nope. Oh, ran out of mana at the last second, and now I have to go against a Muradin. No escapes, no escapes. I keep saying this. We're gonna have to back up here. I don't have anything to really do here, and there's too many people without enough mana and enough health to really deal with this. Illidan might be able to go in there, but I can't really do here. So, Zergling gonna be what I'm gonna pick up. Zergling are just so good. They add just little extra bodies for your opponents to have to deal with. And they do a good amount of damage. They start doing about 30 damage a hit or so at one point, and it's a pretty good, decent amount of damage. So it looks like their Muradin's gonna come over here. We could do a little bit of harassment, maybe just get him to pop a leap or something. Or we could go and do full combo on Kerrigan. She's not going to get out of that, but I will. Oh, no, she got her... Oh, see, that was very nice of her. She used her trait in order to get a little bit of more damage done on the creeps, which gave her a shield that outlasted that Envenom. Very, very nicely played there by the Kerrigan. But still, they don't have a healer either, really. So we are pretty much paired off here. So neither of us really have a healer. It's going to be scary. But look for those people who don't have the escape. Look at that mid lane. Mid lane's actually looking pretty good. There is already a Sergeant Hammer. She just used her W, which is her concussive. They will be able to... Ooh, I might be able to. Oh, no. Doesn't look like it's going to happen. The tumble, as I was saying before, is going to be the crux of you trying to get anything done against that Vala. Look for the opponents with no escapes. Oh, yeah, though. Look at that. That's a little hero damage top of the charts here. Gonna soak some experience. And I'm just gonna guard this over here. Ooh, a free Vala. Oh, don't look like I'm gonna be able to get that one done. Nothing's gonna happen here. Oh, we will pick up Meriden though. And just keep being aggressive. Be aggressive. We're actually just about to hit level 10. I don't know if I can do that much here. Oh, enough damage. Oh, the Zerglings. The Zerglings. Oh, no. They're Zerglings. Oh, our Zerglings are fighting. How unfortunate. I was hoping the Zerglings were able to take it. Well, Maelstrom. Absolutely, undeniably, the best heroic for Kerrigan. Now, Ultralisks are pretty nice. However, gotta love the Maelstrom. It's going to be able to really help us start flexing our team fight ability. And you'll see just how well that's going to give us a ridiculous amount of sustain given our trait, which is that assimilation. 10% of damage dealt from basic attacks and abilities as shields for 6 seconds. So, so great. Great amount of sustain coming out here. The more targets you have, the more overall damage you're going to do with that Maelstrom. We're going to go on here. We're going to pop it in the middle of everything. Ooh, we're going to take a good amount of damage. Actually, might not be able to survive yet. That was a little bit too ham there. Jeez, this is a slugfest. They're going to be able to pick up that last one, though. I don't know exactly what happened there, but we did not win that fight too well. Alright. I have a feeling he did. I didn't hear it. Now I'm complete. So, yeah, looks like a hunt is coming in here from our Illidan. That's going to be interesting. A little bit more single target damage, I guess we would have. In fact, we have a... No, we only have about 2. The cool thing is, might use Concussive Blast, but if they do, it's going to be... You know, if you leaped in there, Concussive Blast would have been the immediate response. But if you just slowly go in there, it's kind of like unexpected. Nobody really sees that coming, and that's actually why I was able to do so much damage there. So we have our Venom up. Look, there's a Gazelle up in the top lane. Looks like a pretty good target to me. No escapes. We have Kael'thas already moving on up there. And the Tribute's right there as well. This looks like this could be a very, very nice place to go. We will top that Envenom on top of that and just do a good amount of damage. Just back up. We got the advantage now in the team numbers, so... Okay. Oh, this is a lot of damage. This is even more damage. This is too much damage. Oh, God. Well, they will get the Meriden? Maybe not. Oh, me, oh, my. The Illidan, though. Can our Illidan come back in? Oh, here comes a hunt. Nice. Nice work on Illidan. See if we can actually finish off maybe the Meriden? Scary. Very nicely played. Now just a siege tank is alive, and oh man, if the Kerrigan was coming up to our fights, that would be so scary. But she's not, so we're actually taking really nice advantage in these team fights. The scary thing is we are really a bunch of squishies, except for our Chen. So level 13 is coming in here. We need a little bit of escape, right? We keep running into these team fights. We're not doing so hot during these team fights. We need to get out of here. Ooh, she did not try to run. Think I might be able to win. Yeah, there we go. That assimilation trait, like, right, she looked like she was going to be able to do so much there, but the assimilation trait was able to just really kind of round that all out. And that really kind of allowed me to take that as a victory. That was those little creeps around me were being able to suck up more damage, and more damage, of course, means more shield, so that was allowing us to really take that home. And that's good, because I was honestly kind of questioning whether or not I was a little bit of an overcommittal. But we'll see in the next couple of teamfights if that Kerrigan's going to actually start joining in here. Again, people decide that they can just fight me. Yeah, there's going to be a leap. That's what I figured as much. Ooh, but if he runs in a predictable pattern, we might be able to pick him up. Illidan versus Avala, and a Gazlo is probably not great, so we might want to go help him. Nope. Team fight for the curse. If we can set up a nice kill right beforehand, remember, we've got that Venom already set up here. So we might just want to be a little bit aggressive here. Just run around in a circle. Oh, ooh, he missed there. Again, as I was saying before, you will miss some of these. Oh, I am taking so much damage. I've got to run. Oh, it's not going to happen. Two people dead. Kael'thas, can you round it out? Kerrigan's coming for you, buddy. Don't do it. Oh, you died. We had a Chen at one point. Looks like, yeah, they're going to be able to get this. But he's going to get the Gasto. Very nice. Very nice there. So, level 16 is on the cusp, but unfortunately... Ooh, and Kerrigan was able to pick up that kill as well. That's a shame. My curse upon. So, level 16, we're going to be able to pick up that Blood for Blood. That's going to help us melt down that Muradin just a little bit quicker. We've got only two Blood for Bloods. Hopefully, our friend is going to pick that up, our Illidan friend. If we can get two Blood for Bloods down on one person, that'd be perfect. I don't know if that's going to happen, but we'll see. So I'm going to see if I can get her in a grasp combo. That's going to allow us to do a little bit better here. Ooh, wow. With the hunt combo. Very, very nicely played there. There's the Blood for Blood to help us out. We just need to actually defend this. Oh, it looks like Gazlo's doing a good... Nazeba's doing a good job of that. And we need to go defend this bot lane. So remember, Kerrigan, just jump at the people who don't probably have the ability to escape from these things. Gazlo is one of the greatest ones. He does have his sprint probably now. No, he doesn't even have a sprint, so we're fine here. We're all fine here. How are you?
Enough.
You can actually take siege camps as well. It's not going to work out so well, but you can take them. With your trait, you're just going to have a whole bunch of shields. And oh no, a little bit of... Okay, I was about to say, I hope we're not going to get into a huge argument here. But we won't. It looks like it was just a... Yup. So all of a sudden, somebody's going to start saying that they're level 1. Yeah, go for it. I don't think they specifically need me. They've got an Illidan. Illidan's able to kind of deal with these things very well. And I can pick up another set of bruiser camps. It's going to be probably better for us anyway. So yeah, we got there. Oh my. This isn't going so well. Pop everything. There's our Omega. There we go. Ooh, did not make it through there though. Siege tank though. Can we deal with the siege tank? Oh wow, the BFG pick. Very interesting. Picked up the Kale. Oh dear, oh my. Well, the Grave Golem in the bot lane is not going to bode so well for us, but we do have our Illidan up, and they've got their Sergeant Hammer, so they're probably going to still lose that top four, so that's going to be an interesting trade here. As long as their Siege Giants are able to stay alive for a little bit longer. Come on, kill that one before he kills you. Yes! Then we get that. So that's going to be a nice little trade. We're not going to lose our top or bottom keep either. We can do a good amount of damage at the bottom fort here. Rough to say, though, we are in a little bit of a tight bind. The 5 deaths. Oh, yeah. 9 deaths on our Kael'thas. That's a little bit unfortunate. And I'm still vying for top hero damage. Their Kerrigan damage is actually doing pretty good keep damage as well. And that's the thing to really note, is that I was saying before, you can go with a whole bunch of different things. You can go for Ultralisk. It does work. It does things. It's pretty nice talent, actually. But I always prefer my Maelstrom. Maybe Maelstrom wasn't going to be the best choice here, just because we don't have the sustain. That is a thing that you always have to consider. It looks like they're going to be able to pick that up. Oh, maybe not. We're going to pick up a couple of kills here. Their Sergeant Hammer is kind of running away. I don't know if I'm going to be able to survive this, but I'm going to try. Yeah, not going to look like it's going to happen. The issue here is that we have no backline. And so everybody kind of just jumps into the backline and we kind of lose it. That is an issue. But there's not much we can really do about it, considering our team. Our Chen might just need to peel just a little bit more. So I'm just gonna say, Chen, help Kel'Thas, please. Use that barrel, push everybody away. We'll see what happens out of that. If not, doesn't work, we lose the game. It's not that big of a deal. We are gonna learn a good amount about Kerrigan, though. Right, because Kerrigan starts to fall off a little bit at the lower, or to the higher stages of the game. Her damage kind of does peak off a bit because you rely a lot around that in Venom and all of your CC, so it becomes a little bit more difficult. But let's pick up that Omega Storm. Does 100% more shield generated while you're in that Omega Storm, and as well as more, there's just more AoE out of it as well, so it makes it a lot easier for you to actually kind of... Ooh, Kel'Thas, you are in a dangerous spot there, buddy. Oh, snap. That's not a good place for me to be. I am the floor. Yep. Nope. Gonna back up. That's a bad place to be. I don't know if I agree with this. Okay, cool. He's gonna back up. That's actually gonna keep them busy for good enough time. Oh, no. Sergeant Hammer's up there. We need to get up there as well. Ooh. Wow. We actually picked up the curse. Very nice. I hope we don't lose anybody for that. I could jump. Threw my blades just a little bit too far that time. Oh, but this is scary. Yep, nope, nope, nope. Gonna use my leap to actually disengage here. That was a good amount of damage, but I don't think I can go back in. Very nice bolt there. Kel'Thas. He should probably go back. I'm gonna wait for my health to start regenerating just a bit before I go back in here. I'm a bit scared. Use my sprint to get back into this. Oh no! A little bit too ham. Oh well. We will probably lose this game. We're gonna take the bottom fort though. There we go. Minor victories. I'm gonna lose the keep. And that's gonna be just the issue, I guess, of, you know, sometimes you don't have the best team to really deal with the composition. Sometimes you do. You know what, looking back at this, maybe Ultralisk was a smarter choice there by the Kerrigan, just because we don't have any healers. But that's up to you, of course. If you're going to be playing with friends, get a dedicated healer. Get an Uther. Oh my god, an Uther with the Kerrigan is so, so nice. Ooh, very nice hunt there. We only lost one keep, so this game isn't quite over yet. Take a little bit of damage on the core, though. Let's go for that. Let's go for that. That is a good call. I'll be up in 10 seconds and I can just have to run right over there. So apologize for taking most of this game as being dead. But that is the nature of... Ooh. A little bit of a fight. There's Apollo there. We can pick up at least one kill, maybe two here. Yep, there's the Pyroblast. That's definitely going to kill him. And we pick up the Grave Golem, so we should honestly just start pushing with this. Or we can do that. Uh-oh. Bit of a bind. Oh my dear god, if I can get out of here. Please, Chen, 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 Chen! I don't really know why Chen didn't dismount her beforehand. He had full health, but I guess that's the thing that happened here. Yes, they need to go for that. But I guess they can go for that as well. Ooh, that was actually really nice. Get the lock in on the Gazlo and pick that up as a kill. That was actually pretty cool. Oh my god, can they get the kill on him as well? Actually, this could potentially turn into a win. If Illidan came in, this might turn into a win, but I don't know if it's gonna happen. Well, if the rest of our team was there, I would have said a core would have been a great call, but unfortunately that just didn't work out so well. Oh my god, I'm coming for you. I'm hoping I can get there. I don't know what's gonna happen. Oh boy. No? Maybe? Okay, that worked a little bit better. That was unfortunate. Probably shouldn't have gone in without full health. Did he take Global Hunt? He did. He probably should have gone back to Fountain. I think he didn't have full health. If he found, he would have had a little bit of a better shot, but unfortunately that's not going to happen. Not today. Yes, they are going to be doing Siege Golem. Yeah, their gas is already there. You can see by seeing just how much siege giant or siege damage is going up, and you don't see anybody actually doing anything, so that's going to mean that they are at the... Oh, no, they're at the Bruisers. Galtha seems to want to do Bruisers, though. Yeah, that was a mistake. Oh, well. We can defend this. Probably. Actually, I'm not so sure about that. We'll see. And that's the power of Orbital BFG. Being able to constantly be able to take that out. However, doesn't mean the game's over. As you saw, we had that one victory. We just need one more of those. Without letting them pick up the next curse.
Who shall die this one? Your enemy has destroyed you.
We need to go fight through this. We need to fight for this pretty badly. I don't know if I can do anything about this, though. Nope. Nope. Yep. That was a mistake. But I don't know if we're going to be able to defend this anyway. Oh, that was a mistake of mine. Kind of was like a last-ditch effort. I thought there was going to be at least just one person there, and then I would have been able to sprint away, but that wasn't really true. And with a curse, with that last keep about to go down, I don't think we're going to be able to defend this too well anyway. However, crazier comebacks have happened. So we're going to lose one person, we're going to lose another, but that's a shame, but that's okay. That's the way the cookie crumbles today. And so Kerrigan will lose, but we will have learned a good amount about Kerrigan, her survivability. It's a bit rough in the solo queue, so make sure that you probably play with a couple of friends if you're going to be playing as Kerrigan. But that's all for today. That's all for this free week. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm SchAmToo. Do me the favor to subscribe, and of course, follow me on Twitter and mlg.tv/SchAmToo. Have a good night.
Marsh runs back, so we need to make sure we're going top, and that's exactly what we're doing. There's a Nova there. Oh, that Nova. Oh, that Nova. She's free. It's free week. Because that Nova's a free kill. Oh, you get the Envenom at the end, and she's going to fall. Envenom is such a good talent for really securing those kills as well. You know, I was saying before, it's good for pushing your opponents away, but it's also good for making sure you get those kills. And you can also just see that unstable poison really just wrecking our opponents here.
and also getting the Wailing Arrow kill. Now, this is the second time in a row that I have used Wailing Arrow to actually just get solo kills.